Oral cancer, again, a very interesting disorder, and we see a fair bit of that too. Again, it's oftentimes a smoking-related phenomenon. Somewhat in the Midwest, maybe tobacco chewing plays a little bit in that game. Oral cancers, again, are complicated because they impact a lot of very social functions, eating, talking, the things we do with our oral cavities. And they're very surgically heavy disorders. I mean, almost all oral cancers need surgical therapy. It's difficult to treat them with chemotherapy. It's difficult to treat them with radiation therapy because the jawbone around the oral cavity makes it difficult to get appropriate doses of radiation in there without damaging things that are essential, like your tongue, like the mandibular architecture, and precluding secondary side effects from that type of treatment. So surgery is heavily used in the oral cavity. But the value of that is we can do that and successfully rehabilitate patients. Again, we do a lot of free tissue transfer. We have multiple surgeons that are capable of doing what are called free flaps, moving tissue from other locations in the body that are kind of redundant that we can use to reconstruct the oral cavity. And so if the jawbone needs to be removed, we can actually rebuild the jawbone. If portions of the tongue need to be removed, we can actually rebuild portions of the tongue. And we've been doing that again for a long, long time. And the patients are really well treated, and they actually function at a very high level. Even with big, big tumors of the oral cavity, we're able to provide high function and high quality of life afterward. It's a complex disorder. Nobody wants to have to deal with it, but we do see it frequently and handle it in that, again, that comprehensive way.